Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Gary Jeezy Duels here today with my agent deck profile for the January 2014 format. I really like agents because we have access to three Christia. Okay, so that's why I'm playing it. Here is the deck profile. For the monsters, we have three Mystic Shine Balls, three Christia, three Hyperion, one Jupiter, two Hecatrice, one Honest, three Venus, three Earth, two Herald of Orange Light, and two Effect Veiler. For spells, we have one Dark Hole, three Mystical Space Typhoon, one Book of Moon, two Forbidden Lance, and two Valhalla Hall of the Fallen. For the traps, we have one Bottomless, one Mirror Force, two Dimensional Prison, one Compulse, two Fiendish Chain, and one Solemn Warning. Extra deck, we have one Michael, the Lightsworn Arc, Black Rose, Ancient Fairy Dragon, Ancient Sacred Wyvern, Vulcan the Divine, Armides, Keeper of Illusions, Cataster, and one Armory Arm. For the XYZs, we have one Mequipengineer, one Temtempo, one Digusto Emerald, one Herald of Pure Light, two Gachi Gachi, and one Dark Mist. Side deck, we have Santa Claus, the Soul Taker, two Twisters, three XYZ Encore, three Mistake. This is a really powerful card. I'll talk about why. And one Soul Drain and two Debunk. So let's go into some of the card choices. Obviously, Christia at 3, I wanted to play 3 Christia in order to utilize its overpowered effect. You know, not only can it stop special summoning, it has 2,800 attack for some reason. As well, when it gets destroyed, it gets sent to the top of the deck. So I thought the best way to abuse Christia is not to use its own special summoning effect to like accumulate 4 fairy type monsters, although that is possible. I think that using Valhalla over and over again is really good, so that if you have Valhalla and then you can go first turn into Christia, it shuts down a lot of decks. Even if they happen to get rid of Christia at that point, Christia goes to the top of the deck, you draw it the next turn, and then you use Valhalla, and then you can summon back the Christia. So it's kind of like an infinite loop with Christia. I really like it. That's why it's at 3. And if you draw into extra Christia, you know, you'll have ways to discard it with Herald of Orange Light. So it's definitely not a dead card in your hand either. For Hyperion, of course, you play at 3. I only play one Jupiter. Jupiter is really good. It's searchable. So first of all, you know, you have 3 Earths, and some people may be thinking, after you use Earth to search for the Venus, your Earths are kind of useless, but that's not the case, because when you use Earth again, the second Earth effect you're getting off, of course, is to search for Jupiter. Jupiter's effect, when you banish a agent-type monster from your graveyard, it goes to 2,500 attack. So, you know, if your opponent has the Evil Swarm Ophion, you can just use this and try to crash into Ophion. It's potentially another out to Ophion, and it's just an agent monster as well. So if it ends up in your graveyard, it has great synergy with Hyperion, and it's just a solid card to run at 1. 2 Hecatrice, because I want to search for the Valhalla. I don't want to use 3 Valhalla, because if you draw into 3 Valhallas, it's kind of bad, so I use 2 and 2. I also like Hecatrice because it's also a fairy type monster, so there are times where if you have a Hecatrice plus a Hyperion, it's still not a bad thing to just use Hecatrice's effect, get Valhalla, use Valhalla, summon out Hyperion, and then use Hyperion's effect, banish the Hecatrice from your graveyard, and destroy a card, so it's technically a plus, and you have a 2,700 monster on the field. I'm not saying do it all the time, but it's possible. Also, the Honest, of course, self-explanatory. You need the 3 agent of Venus and also Earth, because they're the power cards of the deck. It helps you plus, it helps you search. 2 Herald of Orange Light. Despite having 2 of these, I also play 2 Veilers, because monster effects are just really, really prevalent in the meta these days. If you want to use these Herald of Orange Lights when your opponent's using effects that are not on the field, so, you know, so that you can leave when your opponent has like things that activate on the field to the Effect Veiler. So it's a nice balance. Other than that, I play Forbidden Lance. Forbidden Lance is really good because it helps you your Christia survive better. So if your opponent can't get rid of Christia by monster, because, you know, they can't special summon into something big, if they can't get rid of it by monster effects, because you have, you know, Herald of Orange Light, Effect Veiler, as well as Fiendish Chains, what can they do? They must get rid of it by spell or traps. But if you have access to Forbidden Lances as well as MSTs, the chances of your monster surviving is that much higher. Okay, as well, for the traps, there's very standard. I only run one Mirror Force. I like Mirror Force at 1, because it's not always the case that you get to use it. It is a pretty slow card, and a lot of cards in the meta these days prevent themselves from being destroyed. So Having Mirror Force at 1 will surely punish some people when they overextend, but it is not always as useful as, say, Dimensional Prison. Okay, extra deck. Nothing really needs to be talked about. You can go into a lot of these. I play one Vulcan Divine, even though it's rare to go into a level 6 XYZ. I do admit that. Plus the rank 3 XYZs, you know, it's kind of hard to go into that as well. But the beauty of this deck is, other than going into Gachi Gachi every turn, you really just depend on your main deck monsters. So it's potentially a budget deck if you don't have all of these cards. You just basically need the Gachi Gachi and maybe a Dark Mist. But these cards have been reprinted like hell. So it's the chance of you getting it cheap is very easy. So recommend playing this deck if you think you want to go budget. Okay, for the extra deck, 2 Santa Claus. I like this. So sure, you know, in this meta where you have Bujins as one of the top decks, you want to get rid of the Yamato. The best way to do it, you know, just give them Santa Claus. Or if your opponent has a card that controls your field, it has like a Photon Strike Bouncer, has like a Draco Sack, you can just use Santa Claus, remove it instantly. Same thing with same thing with Soul Taker. Soul Taker just helps remove problem threats. Twister removes face up spell of traps, field cards potentially, continuous traps potentially. If your opponent uses something like Royal Decree, you want to get rid of it with Twister. 3 XYZ Encore, of course, I think it's standard side deck for all decks that fear Ophion to some degree, even though there are ways to get rid of the Ophion, especially if you have Jupiter, you have chance with Honest, and you also have a chance with Herald of Orange Light when your opponent's Ophion tries to search. So, you know, you can get rid of Ophion a number of ways, but just in case, you want to use XYZ Encore. Of course, I want to talk about Mistake. Mistake is a very, very good card because almost all top decks, they add to some degree. Hint, hint, Gyrgia. Prophecy. Bujins, because Yamato's effect is add to the hand and then discard. You can prevent all of that with Mistake, and you yourself don't really add that much except for Earth, and it's very negligible because after you add the Venus, you don't really even need Earth's effect. So there's a lot of things that you can do with Mistake. You can also stop Ophion from adding the Evil Swarm spell trap card. You have a lot of options with this, and at 3, I think it's the way to go. It stops a lot of the meta decks and it just wrecks, as well as Soul Drain. I'm so sad that it's at 1. It would wreck the entire meta because nothing popular would get played. Seriously, like Bujins would not be able to activate their effects in the graveyard. Mermails wouldn't be able to work. Light Swarms wouldn't be able to work that well. And it's just a really good card. If it's at 1, I would still play it. It doesn't block you at all, which is really cool because things in your graveyard, you just want to remove as like, costs and stuff. You don't really need them to activate their own effects. As well as 2 Debunk, because your opponent does have like some OP hand traps. You might face Prophecy, you might face Bujins with like their cranes. You want to get rid of them with Debunk. Is just a really good card. As well, it gets rid of cards effects that activate in the graveyard as well, so you know it's very versatile. So I wish you guys would try this. This is really, really cool. I really like the deck, especially with 3 Chrystia. You guys have to really try it to believe how good it is. There is a big weakness to this deck, and that I am afraid is when you draw in consistently. Sometimes you do draw into like 2 Shine Balls, and that might be kind of sad, but you know, most of the time, even if you draw into a Shine Ball, as long as you have Venus, you don't minus 1, you just like break even. That's it. So I hope you guys enjoy this deck profile. I hope you have a lot of fun with it. This is Gary GZ Duels signing out.